evening, everyone. All organizations actually have peaks and troughs, and tonight is a definite peak for us, for we commemorate the 101st birthday of our SOS founder Herman Gmeiner and the 32nd anniversary of SOS Manila. Thank yous are customarily said at the end of a day or an event, but today it will be said at the start and at the end and actually all throughout tonight's event, because tonight is a time of gratitude for us. As a child, you would need someone who truly sees you, who stands by you no matter what, someone who holds you close when you are small and believes in you when you are ready to grow into your own and step into the world. But today, 1 in 10 children and young people are separated from their families, abandoned, neglected, or forced to live in an abusive environment, growing up without the support they need to prepare themselves for their future. The effects of this often last a lifetime, creating a harmful cycle that repeats from one generation to the next. It happens every day, in every country, city, and neighborhood, although we don't always see it. Children are remarkably resilient in the face of such challenges because they have to be. Together, we are here to break this cycle and to prevent it from happening in the first place. Where they have lost their voice, we help them find it again. Where they have lost the ability to trust and connect with others, we show them that they belong. And where they lack confidence, we build up their courage and skills to thrive in the future. Because when a child or young person is cared for and supported, they can become their strongest selves. This is why we are here. This is who we are. I would like at this point to invite all of you to sit down, relax, and enjoy tonight's concert. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Daddy Don. I'm the village director of SOS Children's Village, Lipa. It has been a sad feeling for most of us stuck in the comfort of our homes just to make sure we are safe and healthy against COVID-19. For the past 3 months, we have made stringent measures and disinfection protocol to make sure our children, young people, mothers, and retired mothers are all safe and away from COVID-19. Amid this pandemic, we have made sure our children and young people are still busy with activities to keep them healthy physically, emotionally, and spiritually. They have been doing household chores, morning exercises, gardening, and performances on singing and dancing to keep them away or busy while staying at home and inside the village. They already started their enrollment to online schooling and are attending to scheduled webinars. Added to this, we have converted half of our fish pond in a temporary swimming pool to take away the stress and boredom this pandemic may have caused to the minds of our children, young people, and also to our mothers and retired mothers. It is with great significance that our alternative care for children is helping these children and young people found a home not only to shelter them, but to keep them secure. A family not only for them to belong, but to be loved and taken care of. And a community to develop their full potential as a contributing member of the society in the future. In this time of pandemic, you, our donors, sponsors, and friends, are our strength. Knowing all of us are affected, emotionally, physically, and financially, you have been generous enough to continue on sharing your resources to make sure our children have food in the table to partake, and hygiene kits to keep them safe from infection and other diseases. With the entry of the new normal in our daily lives, we are making sure our children and young people also understand the present situation and how to cope with it. As we dearly wait for the vaccine and pray for the healing of all who were infected, we are also looking forward to seeing you in the village in the near future. Maraming maraming salamat po.
know I love music. And every time I hear something hot, it makes me want to move. It makes me want to have fun. But it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here, it makes me want to...
Magandang gabi and einen wunderschönen guten Abend. I'm very happy to join you today on this very special day as we commemorate the 101st birthday of Herman Gmeiner, Austrian father and founder of SOS Children's Villages. Now, Herman Gmeiner had a vision, a mission that every child should grow up in a home of its own, in a permanent home, surrounded by love, a nurturing family, and in a safe environment. He fulfilled this goal, and starting in 1949, he set out to establish the first of the SOS children's villages in Austria, and he took that commitment further. Today, SOS Children's Villages is present in an astounding 134 countries around the world. Alone in the Philippines, we count 8 villages across the country that are catering to abandoned and neglected Filipino children. I was fortunate enough to meet some of these wonderful children personally during my visit to Cebu last year. A truly unforgettable experience. Thank you for that. Now, children's rights have always been a long-standing priority of Austria's human rights policy, both nationally and on the world stage. The Austrian Embassy in the Philippines has put special emphasis on the promotion of children's rights through a number of special projects for Filipino children and youth. And I'm happy to say that SOS Children's Villages Philippines is one of our important partners in promoting and raising awareness for children's rights. In fact, we've carried out together a number of very meaningful and far-reaching collaborations. You might remember in 2018, we organized together the very successful Loma Wall Child's Rights exhibition, a photo exhibition called Snapshots of a Happy Childhood. Now, this featured children and their day-to-day life under SOS care. I hope you saw that exhibit. It was beautiful and powerful, and it created enormous enthusiasm and support for the important work of SOS Villages. Now, today we are facing a whole series of new challenges. At a time when our world is plagued by a pandemic, allow me to take this opportunity to express my heartfelt gratitude and appreciation to our childcare frontliners and to all COVID-19 frontliners who
who tirelessly and selflessly continue to offer their services in the midst of this most dreaded pandemic. Your bravery, your dedicated spirit in serving others fill us with admiration and continually inspire us to move forward in this battle against COVID-19. Now, on behalf of the Austrian government, on behalf of my staff at the Austrian Embassy Manila, I want to extend my deepest respect and thanks to all the work you have done to ensure our safety and well-being. And to all the children and youth of SOS Children Villages Philippines, please do not forget that as we face this unsettling time and the numerous challenges, you are the source of courage and inspiration to all those around you. I know that you're doing your best to cope, and I'm certain that with resilience, optimism, and resourcefulness, you will find ways to find purpose in this moment of crisis and inspire others to dream, to hope, and to act. I have no doubt that history will highlight the efforts of you young people in all parts of the world who have become instrumental in turning doubt to faith and transforming despair to hope. Now, as Austrian ambassador and representative of a country rich in culture and music, I invite everyone to watch and enjoy this magnificent Thanksgiving online concert with me, and to join me and the entire staff of the Austrian Embassy Manila as we continue our commitment to the SOS Children's Villages so that every child grows with the love, respect, and security it deserves. I wish all of you a wonderful concert and much courage, good health, and safety ahead. Mabuhay, maraming salamat.
Congratulations, SOS Children Philippines!
Stay positive!
Stay grateful!
Stay happy!
Stay safe!
Stay healthy!
And share the power of good nutrition! We love you from your Herbalife Nutrition family!
Hello everyone, I'm Eva Lin from Taipei, Taiwan. I'm the Corporate Communications Director of Herbalife Nutrition, in charge of Herbalife Nutrition Foundation for Asia Pacific region. Our foundation envisions a world where every child has equal access to the healthy nutrition. Back to the year 2010, we started to support SOS Children's Village in Philippines to fulfill this mission. And we will continue supporting SOS for more years to come. My message to the SOS children, we are a power connected, especially under these circumstances. Please stay well and know that we all here for you.
Goes and her body, deep inside.
Hi, I'm Michelle Erica Saldariaga of Pedia Pharma Foundation. As a recipient of the Child Care Champ Award of SOS, we are committed to be part of the SOS family, and we promise to continue to provide scholarships to SOS children and youth and to support their education, which we started way back in 2015. Through these scholarships, we hope to be able to help SOS children and youth achieve a brighter future and a better quality of life. To the children of SOS, be grateful and be blessed that you're all growing up in loving homes through SOS. With our help and the support of your SOS family, you will be able to achieve all of your goals and all of your dreams one day. Nothing is impossible with hard work, determination, and prayers. Never give up. Always have God at the center of your life. And one day when you become successful, don't forget, be generous and also help others. Being part of the SOS family is really a very fulfilling experience, which I'd like to share with others. So for those who would like to share their blessings and make a difference, I invite you to contact SOS Children's Villages and find out how you can help them through their various projects. Thank you, SOS. I love you. Congratulations.
A very big hello to all of the awesome families and kids at SOS Children's Village. My name's Chris. I work at UPS right here in the Philippines, and I'm really, really super duper excited to hear how all of you are celebrating today. I hear it's somebody's very, very special birthday. So we at UPS have had the privilege and honor to meet some pretty special people at the village in Olabon. And I'll tell you something, me and my colleagues just had such a wonderful time playing and hearing your stories and even helping a little bit with your studies. Although for me, I will have to say, it's been some time since I had to do some of that math. And in the end, I think some of you kids were actually teaching me. So I can't help but think back and just see myself smiling during that from that day. So these past few months have been a little bit challenging, as you all know. And I know it's probably been super hard on all of you. So I want everybody to try to keep the faith, stay strong, okay? Most importantly, wear your masks, wash your hands often, and stay safe and healthy. This is what I tell all of my folks at UPS almost every day and my family members every day. Since many of us are stuck at home and not able to go out, even still today, use the time wisely, all right? Keep studying, read more, definitely play more, have fun. More importantly, take care of yourself and take care of each other. We're all going to get through this together. I do hope you have a great time today, and I'm looking forward to seeing and hearing some of the real amazing talent that's coming out of your Thanksgiving program today. All right? You guys have an amazing day.
Yeah. In behalf of SOS Children's Village Iloilo, I would like to share to you an update about the situation in the village. During the pandemic, we make sure that all children, youth, co-workers, and mothers are safe and protected. I gave them an orientation about what's happening outside and the effect of the COVID-19, as well as the preventive measures for their awareness. All children have activities as part of their interventions to cope their emotions. For the donors, thank you so much for their support. It's a really big help to SOS for the needs of our children. Happy birthday, Lolo Minor, and happy anniversary, SOS Manila. Thank you so much.
As a mother, I have an important role to the children, especially this time of pandemic crisis. I conducted family meeting to inform the children about the virus. I guide them in their daily routine, especially like proper hygiene, wearing a face mask, hand washing. And we also conduct activities in the village like tutorials, virtual class, and sport fest. Sometimes they join us in gardening because these activities, the children feel secure and they don't feel alone. Thank you for all those who continue to help us during this time of pandemic. Happy anniversary, SOS Manila, and happy birthday, Lolo Herman Gmeiner.
Kumakaway, sumisilip, ibang klaseng init.
Kapag tayo'y magkalapit, gumiginto ang langit.
Unti-unting tumudungaw, ibang klaseng araw.
Liwanag na sumasaya, pag-ibig na umaabaw.
Kung saan-saan ako, dinadala ng ngiti mo.
Summer is love.
Sumisipol na hangin.
Kung saan-saan ako dinadala na
Don't think about it, just move your body. Listen to the music, sing oh eh oh. Just move those left feet, go ahead, get crazy. Anyone can do it, sing oh eh.
Hi, SOS Village. My name is Pete Hayden. I'm the country head of Capital One Philippines right here in Alabang. First off, I just want to thank you for our partnership that we have together. At Capital One, we believe in the youth of the Philippines, and it's what makes up our amazing workforce here. So when we had the opportunity to partner with you, we knew it was absolutely the right thing to do. I want to thank you, and I also want to give a special shout out to the 12 kids that live in the Capital One house and our amazing house mother, Miss Yang. We are so proud of you and so excited to continue our partnership and see what lies ahead. Together, we're gonna do great things, and you have our commitment to be a great partner with you and help you, and thank you so much for everything.
with all the events that have unfolded in 2020, I think it's critical now more than ever that we care for our children and acknowledge the spirit of community and solidarity we all share during these trying and unsettling times. I know this has been a difficult year for our children and caregivers at SOS Village Philippines, but I also hope you all know that you have a voice, that we are listening, and that we are here for you. Your resilience through all of these challenges has truly been inspiring. I encourage everyone and anyone to get involved with SOS Village Philippines. Every child deserves someone to be there for them no matter what, who shows them they belong and makes them feel safe and understood. Thank you.
Hi, SOS Children's Village. This is Rob Nunnally from Capital One. It was such an amazing honor to meet you earlier this year and to start our Capital One house. I want to thank you for taking care of the kids that are part of our partnership, and we are so excited to continue working with you later this year. Stay safe, safe and healthy. We miss you, and we'll talk soon.
Attention, please. If dancing is not your thing, please step aside. The next DJ act will take you to another level of happiness. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hi everyone, this is Zof Garcia from Pfizer Philippines Foundation. So I hope everyone is safe, and of course, kami mga kuya at ate nyo, uncle and auntie. We hope everyone is safe during this pandemic. We simply support the foundation and the organization because we believe that no child should be left alone. And we actually at Pfizer Philippines Foundation actually agree and we felt the need to support these children who are actually in need and who are abandoned here in the Philippines. Kami sa foundation, we want each and everyone to have a loving family na may uuwian, na may mag-aalaga sa kanila. So which is why we at PPFI truly believe in the goal and focus of Mr. Herman Gmeiner. My message in behalf of Pfizer Philippines Foundation is very simple. We just want everyone to keep safe during this pandemic. But of course, second of which, our message is we, your uncles and aunties at Pfizer, are here to support you all the way. We're always here to provide you with opportunities for the future. And we're always here to provide you as your guidance. Being an uncle, alam po namin na, of course, you have to set an example. So kami po, you all can always count on us if you want help on your homeworks or financial support or in any need. Pwede niyo po kaming puntahan. You can visit us at our office. I believe some of the children have visited our office at 8 Rockwell. And we're always here to support you and be your uncle and auntie. Sarap panging uncle and auntie. To everyone who are don't know what the organization is, please, we would like to invite everyone to support the organization. Of course, I believe ang sabi nun sa amin nun is siguro it would be best to visit the village itself. And when we visited the village for the first time, it really felt like home. Na-meet namin ang mga mommies, ang mga nanay, together with the kids. And when we were there, it's a totally different experience. So, of course, I would want everyone to be to experience the loving care of a family. So we at Pfizer Philippines Foundation are truly excited to see you again during this pandemic. So yun lang po. And again, in behalf of Pfizer Philippines Foundation, this is Uncle Joff. We hope to see you again soon. Miss ko na po kayong lahat, to be honest. So gusto lang po namin kayong makita and ingat kayo lagi. Alright? Bye-bye!
Oh. wish I may, wish I might, have this wish I wish tonight. When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in a dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Like a boat out on the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Like a boat out on the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dream.
Hello, I'm Omar Maxwell Espina, president of the SOS Children's Village in Cebu. Today, we celebrate the 101st birth anniversary of our founding father, Dr. Herman Gmeiner. I met Dr. Gmeiner in the early 80s when he came to visit the Philippines. And I got to know about his ideas from a little green book that he wrote that contains all his ideas about how to raise children or children who have lost their natural families through being orphans or being abandoned. And this book contains all his ideas about this matter. But it was through Dr. Helmut Kutin, who was at that time the Secretary General of SOS Children's Village International, that I got to know about SOS in depth. Dr. Kutin was building several villages in the Philippines at that time, for which we were the architects. And I got to meet him quite often. And in these visits to the Philippines, he would talk a lot about SOS. And I learned that the SOS is based on four principles, the four principles that were defined by Dr. Herman Gmeiner. The essentials that create the environment for these children, the abandoned and orphaned children, to grow up in. And these four principles are, first, a mother, very essential to him. Second is brothers and sisters or siblings. Together with the mother, they form the family unit, which, according to Dr. Gmeiner, was the best environment for a child to grow up in, as contrasted with children who, or abandoned children who are placed in institutions. The third principle is the house. A house that can accommodate this single unit family and that is expected to stay there all their lives. That means even when they have left the village, they have something to come back to. It is an anchor in their lives. The fourth is the village itself, which is composed of several of these houses grouped together. The idea being that these families of similar circumstance would be able to support each other. So these are the four principles that Dr. Gmeiner enunciated in his little green book. At that time, I quickly caught on to the idea. I knew that it was correct, no? That these children who are abandoned would seek and immediately find love, caring, and security in an environment that is like that. A recreated environment, of course, but still much better than if they were put into or herded into institutions. So that was the beginning of my engagement with SOS. It's been several years now. Eventually, I became a member of the board of the SOS village in Cebu, and now I'm president of the village in Cebu. I also represent the village in the national board in Manila, and I do not regret having devoted so much effort and time in this organization, because I believe that it has done a lot for our children. I gain a certain amount of fulfillment when I see the children grow up in this environment and become fully functioning valuable members of society. Several of our children have become professionals on their own right, earning their own keep and raising families that are well raised. My engagement with SOS was very easy to get into, because at that time when we were first introduced to SOS, we already saw existing villages. At that time, specifically the village in Tacloban and the one in Lipa. So it did not take too much convincing. No? I saw how the children there bloomed, in spite of the fact, for example, that they were just adopted into the village. Let's say they've been there for about 2, 3, 4 weeks, and immediately they had bloomed, no? In that short period of time, after having lost parents, for example, which can be very traumatic in a child's life. But they rebounded quite fast, and it is true what Dr. Gmeiner says, that these recreated families are very beneficial to children of this type. I hope you see the value of these villages and decide to support it yourselves. I would like to invite our friends of SOS and all the people who view this to help SOS in its mission. You can imagine that it requires quite a bit of funding to run these villages and to keep our children healthy. even in a very simple lifestyle, it does still require some amount of money. And we depend on your generosity to help us fund this movement. If you can come visit our village, you will see how well your funds, the funds that you donated, are spent. They are very wisely spent, and we do keep a good eye on how these expenses are kept. So there are many ways by which you can support SOS. It can be a one-time donation, but we prefer continuing donations because it's easier to determine the amount of money that we can generate within a year and budget accordingly. Any donation will do, no matter how small. You are welcome if you wish to support this very laudable movement, and we will be very thankful if you are able to donate whatever amount you can. Thank you.
A family does not have to be by blood, but sometimes can be by heart. Sa mga kapatid ko sa SOS, miss na miss ko na kayong lahat. Hindi man tayo magkasama-sama ngayon, but always remember that you are all in my thoughts and prayers every single day. Alam ko na darating din ang panahon na we can all live without fear and paranoia. I'll get to see your beautiful smiles again. Alam ko na ibibigay yung sa atin ni Papa God. But for now, stay safe and stay home there. And of course, don't forget to pray. I'm inviting everyone to show your support for SOS Children's Villages Philippines. Let's show our heart and home to these children. And let us be an extended family to them. We'd love you to be part of our growing family. Thank you so much.
Happy anniversary, SOS Manila! Happy anniversary, SOS Manila!
Woo! Congratulations for your 32nd anniversary. Congratulations. I know in these trying times, we are doing the best we could to make sure that our children are safe. We also honor our founder, Dr. Herman Gmeiner, on his 101st birth anniversary. Itong nangyayari ngayon, napagsubok na dinadaanan natin. Kung babalikan lang natin, ano kayang gagawin ni Dr. Gmeiner kung nandito siya? Walang pagkakaiba. Ang unang gagawin niya ay ma-make sure na mga bata ma-secure, maging safe. SOS Children's Village Manila, in your anniversary, is a beacon to all of us in SOS Children's Villages in Philippines to work hard and remain steadfast in the service to our children and young people. Marami pa tayong magagawa para sa ating society, much more sa ating mga bata.
Good day, everyone. The authority of the Freeport area of Bataan, or AFAB, has been supporting the SOS Children's Villages Philippines because we believe that we have a very important role to work with other agencies so that we could inspire the community to care for our children. Our children have so much potentials in them. They can lead us to become a better society. The SOS Children's Villages Philippines precisely leads these children to continuously dream and to see how they can be better individuals, not only for themselves but for others as well. To the children and youth of the SOS Children's Villages Philippines, remember that you are valued and loved. Continue inspiring others with the good things you can share. Continue working hard for your dreams. Thank you for making us part of your Thanksgiving online concert as we observe the 101st birthday of your founder, Mr. Herman Gmeiner. We invite everyone to support the SOS Children's Villages Philippines. Any contribution, no matter how big or small, goes a long way for our children. Like us, make them part of your commitment. So be an SOS Children's Villages Philippines partner today.
It's Erica.
Hey guys, it's Shelley.
Hello everyone.
Hey, what's up? And happy anniversary, SOS Children's Villages.
Happy, happy anniversary.
Congrats and happy anniversary. Thank you for another year of supporting these children and bringing them up to be really good people and nurturing them.
SOS Children's Villages Philippines is a home for many orphaned and abandoned children. Although this community does not just provide a home, but also a family.
I do believe in the values that they try to instill in their community. And I really love how sustainable and long-term their plans are for the children.
They give care and support to abandoned children. They give them a second chance to a better life. And these are basically the next generations to come for the Philippines that could really make a difference.
Having met them last year and getting to know them a little bit, I really believe that they have everything in them to achieve their dreams, and I feel like we should do our part in supporting those dreams.
Para sa mga nanay at tatay po, maraming salamat dahil patuloy niyong inaalagaan yung mga bata. Alam naman kasi natin na mahirap ang panahon ngayon. So, maraming salamat dahil nandun kayo para sa kanila. at sa mga bata, sana magkita-kita tayo ulit soon kung okay na yung lahat. And, you know, please stay safe, please stay healthy.
Pagpatuloy niyo sanang mag-aral ng mabuti, mangarap ng malalim, mangarap na may puso, at huwag na huwag niyo kakalimutan ang halaga ng pagiging makapwa-tao.
Always do your best, work hard, and strive to be better.
Namimiss na namin kayo, and sana makasama ulit namin kayo next time. Siguro pagkatapos nitong pandemic. Pero ingat kayo palagi at lagi namin kayo iniisip. If you wanna, we can run away. I know you think about it every day. How can I say no to that pretty face? Baby, we can leave it there. Te juro como tú me gusta, no me gusta nada. Hace tanto tiempo que en mis sueños te buscaba. Quiero estar contigo cada madrugada y que me despierte con un beso tu mirada. Baby, let's run, 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 run away.
Hey guys, it's Kuya Joseph, right? I wish I was there in person. I always wish I was there in person. I miss you guys so much in that beautiful, beautiful village. So, just a quick message from the children is that you continue, even from our distant land, and now we can only communicate through video, you still inspire me and everybody that we know so, so, so much every single day. So stay strong in pandemics and horrible situations like this that the world has to go through. The search for inspiration and the need for happiness and joy is just that much more important. And that's the kind of thing that you guys bring. So please keep up that wonderful, cheerful, positive vibe. And I wish you all the best. Sending so much love from me and everyone around. All the best. Bye. So I support SOS Children's Villages in the Philippines because I've been there and I've met the children and I've seen firsthand the impact of the incredible work that they do. These children come from all sorts of backgrounds, but definitely not easy backgrounds. And to put them straight into this extremely supportive mechanism of this family and that wonderful supportive ecosystem that happens there within SOS, it really makes such a huge difference for their future. And we've been lucky enough to see that firsthand, meet them and get to know them throughout various months, even years by now. And that's why I really support SOS Children's Villages. And then finally, I would like to invite all of you, of course, also to support SOS. and show love in terms of getting involved. If you have a business or an individual, just come and meet the children when we're allowed to, once all of this stuff is over. But until then, find out what they're doing, follow them online, get in touch with the organizers, or indeed me. I'd be happy to share my experiences, because it's really a valuable experience and the kids need that support. So please show your support for SOS Children's Villages in the Philippines, because they need your help. Thank you.
Hello, my friends. Many greetings from Germany. Happy anniversary, SOS Children's Villages Manila. I want to thank you for your good work and your kindness, because I know how it is to be alone. Lost my mother when I was young. I hope I can do some more supports to you and encourage some people to do as well. Okay, I hope you stay well and healthy. Hopefully we see one day in real. Bye bye.
Happy anniversary, SOS Manila. I wish you all the best and more blessings to come. I would like to ask everyone else also to reach out to these gifted children, and little support or big support, it really doesn't matter. They deserve the best. So hopefully you get the chance to visit them or to reach out and send out your love and support. I wish you all the best. Happy anniversary po ulit.
Hi kids, I'm sure you've been asking your mama why you can't go out just yet to play, or why you can't go back to school. And I'm sure your mama's also explained to you why. We need you to stay at home so that you can keep yourself and your families healthy. Remember, you are the next generation, the future of this country. So please stay safe and healthy. I also hope that you take the time during the quarantine period, during this concert, and every day to enjoy the company of your mama, your brothers and sisters. Please also continue to help each other every day in whatever way you can. If you wish to make an impact to our nation's future, invest in the next generation. You can do this by supporting the SOS Children's Villages Philippines. We in RCBC Bankcard make it easy for our customers to do so. So if you want to help, please contact RCBC Bankcard. You can also reach out to SOS Children's Villages Philippines or check out our websites for more details. Thank you.
For the young and young at heart, over at SOS Children's Villages, our message is to please remain hopeful for the future, and also to listen to your aunties and uncles at SOS, and also lastly, to become leaders in your own communities. As we like to say in Unilever Philippines, sama-sama, tulong-tulong. Thanks to the continued work of SOS Children's Villages here in the Philippines and all over the world, we are also able to continue our mission of making sustainable living commonplace. Speaking as a person who continues to believe in them and their mission, I would like to invite everybody to check out ways to help and support SOS Children's Villages Philippines now. Thank you.
Hi, this is Toff Rada from Mondelez, Philippines, and I would like to congratulate SOS Children's Villages for staging a successful event. I'd like to also say that we're very proud to partner with this organization as it aligns with our global purpose on supporting mindful snacking through relevant community partnerships such as these. My message for the children in SOS Children's Villages is, keep studying hard. Work towards a better future, and of course, don't forget your health. It's very important, especially in situations such as these, that you always remain healthy. And you can do that through proper nutrition, eating correctly, and make sure that you are ready to face the challenges that we will be facing in the future. So I'd like to invite also all like-minded individuals and organizations, if you are so inclined, to please help support SOS Children's Villages. It'll definitely be worth your time and your resources. Thanks.
Hello po, Uncles and Aunties. Stay safe po.
There's a breeze in your heart, and I know that it is love. This place better than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if
and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me.
If you want to know why, there's a love that can ally. Love is strong, the cares of joyful giving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel. Fear of dread, stop existing and start living. Can we feel the love?
Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying, you can care enough for living. Make a better place for you and for me. Heaven is